So hey, hello everyone. So this video I'm going to show you how to implement cat command in Linux by using C program language. So currently I'm going to do this program in C language in my text editor, and then I will go to ReplyT and show you how to implement it in Linux. So currently let's get started. So first start with the header files. So it's going to be as include stdio.h, then we are going to use string.h, okay, to get the name of the file name, okay, string. So basically cat command is basically just used to display the contents of the file in a printed form. So there are actually many functions of it, but the primary function is to just to display the contents of a particular text file. So okay, so next thing what we're going to do is going to be int main, and it's going to be int argc comma char asterisk argv. Okay, so argc, int argc refers to the number of arguments that are passed. So we are going to pass it as a command line argument, the file name, and char argv refers to the file name. Okay, this is the number of arguments, and this is the argument name. So that's good. And next we are going to define a file, okay, file pointer. So it's going to be file asterisk, and let's name it as fptr. That's a good name, file pointer. And next we're just going to open it, fptr is equal to f open. To open the file, it's going to be f open argv of 1. Okay, it's not arg of 0, because when we are running the file dot slash header out, and we will specify the file name, we're running the particular C program in Linux. So dot slash header out, it takes the argument of the index number 0. So argv of 1 refers to the file name. And we are going to open this in a form of read. Okay, we are just only going to read, we are not going to edit anything again. So this makes sense. These are basic C++ commands, okay, just to how to open and read a file. And next thing is the if condition. Okay, suppose if you don't give any argument, suppose if you are giving too many arguments or too less arguments, we need to print it in a form of error. So it's going to be not equal to fptr, no file name is given, okay, or okay, and this is r. So r refers if any one condition is true, it accepts in it, and or argv of, so both the conditions should be false to, what to say, to prevent it from getting an error. So it's going to be argc not equal to 2. So it's not equal to 2 because it's equal to 2, this condition is false. But if it's no, it's not equal to 2, means we need two arguments. One is going to be a dash dash error out, another one is going to be the file name. So that's why we are specifying there two arguments. So here we can just type anything our way. So it's going to, I will print it as error. Okay, so that's very good. So next, here comes the main part, and I think this is optional, this lines of course, just to make your code more generic if in case somebody types less or more arguments or null values. So here comes the main part to display it. So we are going to use a character. We are going to read the contents in the file by using each character. So one character we are going to extract from the file and we're going to display it. So it's like character wise iterating to a file. So it's going to be while, okay, while ch equal to f get c of fptr. So we are getting the f get c fetches the each character and gives it to ch. Okay, so ch will have each character, and once the while loop is running, ch will be passing, going on till the next character present in the file. Okay, this while loop will run as, okay, I will then display it. I will tell you the while end condition. So next thing, we're just going to print it. Okay, printf is going to be %c, and it's going to be comma ch. So we are just printing. So this loop, while loop, will go on infinite loop, and when we need to terminate this loop. So this loop terminates when our file has reached an end, a null point, or the end of the file, last character. That's going to be specified not equal to eof. So that's eof stands for end of the file, so last character. And so we have done. So now last thing to close the file, f close, it's going to be fptr. Okay, fptr. Okay, fptr over here also. So I think that's the problem. Let's check for any other errors. Other, okay. Here is one error. You need to close it. Okay, actually, this can cause a serious error. This comes inside this bracket. Okay, this whole. Okay, So this whole thing comes in a form of one bracket. So we need to be very careful here. Sometimes this may even be notified as an error. So that's what I'm saying. So now let's just copy this piece of code. I think we are good to go. So you can even run and check it out over here, but I think that's unnecessary. Let's directly go to RepLIT. So just search RepLIT Linux. So, and you need to sign in so that you can save your work and create your REPL. Okay. So just click new REPL once you have signed in. Okay. You just click bash and name something as, I will name it LATEST. Latest and create REPL. Okay, so our REPL will be getting created immediately. So can they have some dot shell program? So now we are just going to create our own directory. So it's going to be created by mkdir. I will name the directory as new. So as you can see, I have a directory named new created. So I will make this directory as the current directory. So cd, these are all Linux commands. Okay, new cd new name of the directory, and if I put pwd, as you can see here, our new is the current directory now. So now we need to create a text file so that we can display the contents of the text file by using cat command and our return c program command. So for creating a file, you need to use touch. Okay, it's going to be touch txt1.txt. I will name it the text file as txt1.txt and hit enter. So as you can see here, now our text file is created and it's currently blank. I will enter anything. I'll enter hello everyone and save it. And now if you go and use cat command, cat and txt1.txt, you will get hello everyone. So that's how cat command works. Now we are going to implement this by using our code that we have written in our text editor. So we need to create a C program. Okay, so it's going to be touch and name this file as cpro.c. Okay, as you can see here, we have got our .c file and it's currently blank. So now we will just paste the code that we have copied earlier and save it. And now we need to run it. So it's going to be, we need to compile it first. So gcc cpro.c. Okay, this is how we need to compile a C program. Hit enter. So there's no errors and we will get a .a.out file, which is the binary file. So after compiling that, we get that. So now we need to pass two parameters. One is going to be the default .a.out, which you need to get the output and execute the file, and another one is going to be the file name. Okay, as you can see, that's why I've given here not equal to two arguments, and argument of 0 is going to take .a.out, and argument of 1 is going to be the file name. That's why I'm using here f open argument of 1. So that's the reason. I hope now you understand that. So now let's do it. .a.out, and we will pass over here the name of the file. So our name of the file is txt1. And another important thing is that both the C program and the text file should be in the same directory. Okay, otherwise I think you need to specify the whole path. It creates a lot of complexness. So to avoid that, better have it in the same directory. So it's going to be txt1.txt, and now if you hit enter, I think if it's good, it will come. Hello everyone. Sorry, the name of the, I didn't enter txt. Okay, txt1.txt. Okay, so as you can see here, I've got hello everyone. So our content of the file is getting written. Suppose if you want to change anything, I will change it as hello everyone, some blah blah blah. And if I go again, so suppose you have changed the text, you need to compile it again. So gcc cpro, be very careful with the names. Okay, cpro.c. So it's compiled. So our current text is some hello everyone, some random text. So now if I display it, .a.out, file name txt1.txt. So you can see the same thing, that random text is also getting displayed. So we have now successfully implemented our cat command by using C programming language. So minus a programming channel. If you have, I can also check out my other videos. I've done programming in 3D modeling using Blender, game dev using Unity, Java, C++, many other things. So check the my other videos, and thanks for watching.